हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर शीतल कुलकर्णी एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू बायोमेडिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन यूनिट 1 बायोपोटेंशियल एंड देयर मेजरमेंट। एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्टिविटी ऑफ सेल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड स्पेसिफिकेशन। इलेक्ट्रिकल सिग्नल्स, वी हैव लर्न टिल नाउ हाउ कैन अ सेल जनरेट सच अ इलेक्ट्रिकल सिग्नल्स। The cell membrane of each neuron are ion pumps, which are protein molecules that span the membrane and use metabolic energy to transport some ions inside the cell and others outside. Electrical activity is the study of the electrical properties of biological cells, tissues, and organs. It includes measurement of change in voltage or electric current on a far-ranging variety of scales, from single ion channel proteins to entire organs like heart. Let us learn the electrical properties of cell membranes. Biological membranes are electrical insulators due to their phospholipid bilayer structure and are impermeable to ions unless specific ion channels are temporarily open. Only substances that can pass through the hydrophobic core can diffuse through cell membrane unaided. Further, we will see how cell membrane acts as a capacitor and responds to spherical cell to electrical stimuli. Then again, the response of cylindrical cell to electrical stimuli. One of the simplest physiological unit is the cell. It has the power of maintaining itself alive given suitable surroundings. The endocrine pancreas consists of clusters of cells called islets of Langerhans. Most of the cells in an islet are insulin-secreting beta cells. Electrical impulses or action potential are generated in burst when the bath or blood glucose level is in the stimulatory range. Insulin inefficiency is generally a result of beta cell damage by autoimmunity. Closing endocyne triphosphate, that is ATP, in the last slides we have seen ATP, sensitive K-positive channels, that is KATP, in response to glucose increase is generally considered the initial event that depolarize the beta cells membrane and activate the voltage dependent CA2 plus channels, which triggers the release of insulin. However, glucose is unable to extract insulin release if electrical activity and the accompanying CA2 plus influx are prevented. Thus, beta cell electrical activity is a key element in the series of steps cumulative in glucose-induced insulin secretion. Let us learn the cell membrane as an electrical capacitor. An electrical capacitor is a charge storing device, which consists of two conducting plates separated by an insulating barrier. Because of the lipid bilayer of the plasma membrane forms an insulating barrier separating the electrically conductive salt solution of the ICF. ICF is nothing but the intracellular fluid, and ECF, that is extracellular fluid. The plasma membrane behaves as a capacitor. When a capacitor is hooked up to a battery, the voltage of the battery causes electrons to leave one conducting plate and to accumulate on the other plate. This charge separation continues until the resulting voltage gradient across the capacitor equals the voltage of the battery. The amount of charge Q stored on the capacitor at that time will be given by Q is equal to C into V, where V is the voltage across the capacitor and C is the capacitance. Capacitance is directly proportional to the area of the plates and inversely proportional to the distance separating the two plates. Capacitance also depends on the characteristics of the insulating material between the plates, which is the lipid of the plasma membrane in the cells. Biological membranes have a capacitance of approximately 10 raised to power minus 6 farad, that is 1 microfarad per centimeter square of the membrane area. From this value of the membrane capacitance, the thickness of the insulating lipid portion of the membrane can be estimated, and it is given, it is shown in this slide, that is x is equal to epsilon naught k upon c, where x is the distance between conducting plates, c is the capacitance of the plasma membrane, epsilon naught is the permittivity constant, and it is equal to 8.85 into 10 raised to power minus 8 microfarad per centimeter. K is the dielectric constant of the insulating material separating the two conducting plates. The calculated membrane thickness is approximately 4.5 nanometer, which is similar to the membrane thickness of approximately 7.5 nanometer estimated with electron microscopy. The thickness estimated from capacitance is less because it is determined by the insulating portion of the membrane. Whereas the total membrane thickness including associate proteins is observed through the electron microscope. Electrical response of the cell membrane in this slide. Electrical response of the cell membrane to injected current. Many electrical signals in nerve cells arise when ion channels open in the plasma membrane, allowing flow of electric current carried by ions to move across the membrane and alter the membrane potential of the cell. This situation can be experimentally by placing a microelectrode inside a cell and injecting charge into the cell through the microelectrode. It is shown in the figure. The response of the cell to injected current considering only the capacitance of the cell membrane. If the constant current I is injected into the cell, then the charge Q is added to the membrane capacitor at a constant rate I is equal to dQ by dt. Because Q is equal to C into V for a capacitor, I is equal to C into dV by dt. The rise of voltage during injection of constant current in a cell, it is shown. Only the contribution of the membrane capacitance is considered and the effect of membrane resistance is neglected. During the injection of charge at a constant rate, the resulting voltage of the membrane capacitor rises linearly. Next is the addition of resistance in series with the capacitor diagram. In this slide, it is shown the addition of resistance with the capacitor. The current flowing through the capacitor, it is given by I is equal to C into dV by dt, which is equal to constant. The current flowing through the resistance is given by Ohm's law and it is equal to I is equal to V upon R, which is connected with the capacitor. And the total effect of capacitance and resistance, it is given by I is equal to V upon R plus C into dV by dt. Addition of resistance in series with the capacitor diagram. The rise of voltage during injection of constant current into a spherical cell considering both the capacitance and the resistance of the cell membrane. The membrane capacitor represents the insulating portion of the cell membrane and the membrane resistor represents open ion channel that allow charge to move across the membrane. At the onset of the injected current, all the injected charge initially flows onto the membrane capacitance. As the voltage on the capacitor builds up progressively, more of the current flows to the resistance and finally all the current flows to the membrane resistance. And it is given by Ohm's law V is equal to I into R. Response of the current injection in a cylindrical cell. In a spherical cell, as it is shown, the injected current flows equally to the resistors and capacitor in all the parts of the membrane at the same time. However, neurons typically give rise to many long thin neurites that extended long distances to make contact with other cells. Current injected in the cell body of the neuron, for example, must flow along the interior of the neurite to reach the portion of the cell membrane located in the neurite at a distance from the cell body. In this situation, current does not have equal access to all parts of the membrane. The analogous electrical circuit for a long cylindrical cell is shown in this slide. To reach the parallel resistor and capacitor at progressively more distant portion of the cell membrane, current injected at one end of the cell must flow through the resistance provided at the interior of the cell. These resistance can be quite large for cylindrical neurites of neurons. The resistance of the cylindrical conductor, it is given by R. And as it is shown on the slide, R is equal to small r into 4 into small l divided by pi into d square, where R is the specific resistance of the conducting material, L is the length of the cylinder, d is the diameter of the cylinder. For the cytoplasm of neurite, R is approximately 100 ohm centimeter, which is about 107 times worse than the copper wire. This neurite 1 micrometer in diameter will have internal resistance of approximately 1.3 into 10 raised to power 6 per micrometer of length. The current in the site of injection divides into two components. Some of the current flows onto the parallel membrane resistance and capacitance at the injection site. The remainder of the current flows through the internal resistance of neurite. At the next portion of the neurite, the current again divides into the membrane and longitudinal components. Thus, the amount of current declines with the distance along the neurite. In addition, current entering the parallel RC circuit at each position changes with respect to the time, because the voltage on the capacitance at each local position builds up, as I described previously for the spherical cell. As a result, the change in the membrane voltage produced by the current injection in the cylindrical cell varies as a function of both time and distance from the injection site. This is all about the electrical activity of a cell. Thank you, students.